This is Avenue with Bird Inquiry and I am Tahir. Today the topic and the discussion in plant breeding and genetics is historical development of plant breeding. So we divide it into four era: pre-Mendelian era, Mendelian era, then post-Mendelian era, and the last one is the modern era. So let us discuss the breeders or scientists were those who participate in plant breeding in pre-Mendelian era are Millington, then Camerarius, Fairchild, and Joseph Colliotto. So one by one discuss them. Millington in 1676. He knows the male reproductive organ in plants and call it as anther. Next is Camerarius, Camerarius. In 1694, he recognized the sex cells and reproductive organ in plant cells. He says that like animals, plants have also reproductive organs. So next is the Fairchild. In 1717, so he discovered, he crossed with some of the crop varieties and he developed a plant, but it was sterile. That is why it was called as first artificial hybrid, which was sterile, produced by Fairchild. Also was called as Mule of Fairchild. Next is Joseph Colliotter, Colleuter, from 1760 to 1766. He worked on tobacco plants, crossed them, and then create a first fertile plant into the tobacco crop. So next era is Mendelian era. We start from 1900 and end in 1920. Pre-Mendelian era is before the 1900. So Mendelian era, first of all, the three scientists who they discovered, they rediscovered work of Mendel. They were Davis, Cornes, and Simarck. So Mendel work was concluded on two main laws of genetics: segregation and independent assortment. So the next is Hugo de Vries in Mendelian era. In 1902, before this we will like to explain about the Nilsson Ehle, N-I-L-S-O-N-E-H-L-E, in 1901, after the rediscovery of the Mendelian work in 1900 by the three scientists. The next should be explained the scientist Nilsson Ehle. In 1901, he tells about the pure line selection in wheat, barley, and oat. What is pure line selection? When plant is repeatedly self homozygosity increase and heterozygosity decrease. After 8 to 10 years, 99 100% homozygosity will be produced. This is pure line selection. It was known by Nilsson Ehle. Next is Hugo Davis. In 1902, he proposed the mutation theory. And after this, mutation breeding phenomena was also developed by this mutation theory. Next is Bateson and Punnett. In 1905, they proposed the term linkage by working on sweet peas. They say that the genes found on the same chromosomes, when they are most closely found on a chromosome, they move together towards the next generation. Then next is Bateson and Punnett. This have been discussed. Next is G.H. Schell in 1900 and East in 1905. They work on maize and discover the inbreeding are self-cross for knowing about the hybrid vigor. So next is G.H. Schell in 1914. He proposed the heterosis. Next, Nilsson Ehle, I have already told to you. Then next is the post-Mendelian era. We start from 1921 to 1950. In this era, the first scientist is Dustin, D-U-S-T-I-N. In 1934, he discovered colchicine for dusting on the plants to convert the diploid into tetraploid and then into hexaploid, means for doubling the chromosome number. Colchicine is a product released by the Liliaceae family plant called Colchicum anatomnale. So next is Avery and Noble. They work and on doubling the chromosomes practically, so they apply the colchicine. They are first scientists to apply the colchicine to doubling the chromosome number. Dustin simply discovered colchicine and then Avery and Noble applied it to the plants for doubling the chromosome number. Next is Müller, M-U-L-E-R, Müller, 1927, work on Drosophila by X-rays, and the same work was done by Stadler, S-T-A-D-L-E-R, 1928 on barley with reference to X-rays. Next is Vavilov, is the well-known Russian scientist from 1916 to 1925, for about 10 years work on introduction, plants introduction, and then the origin of species, center of origin of species. He found 8 centers throughout the world. So next is the R-H-O-D-A, Rhodes, in 1933, work on cytoplasmic male sterility CMS on the males. And next era is the modern era, which starts from 1950 to till today. The three scientists in this era are well known: Painter, Walker, and then N.E. Barlow. Painter, in 1959-51, he proposed that how to develop a insect resistance in plants, and then Walker in 1953, he tells how to develop disease resistance in plants, and then last one, N.E. Borlaug, B.O.R.L.A.U.G., in 1961, also known as father of the Green Revolution. He used for this Norin 10 gene from the variety of wheat, Norin 10 variety, which is a dwarf variety. So as the problem for spring wheat was lodging at that time, so use these genes, which also named as Norin 10 gene, inserted into this spring wheat to convert into the dwarf variety for protecting against the lodging. The result was the Green Revolution due to this act of N.E. Barlaug. He was also awarded by the Nobel Prize in 1970. So this was all about the historical development in plant breeding, which is linked with the Mendel, who died in 1984. Thank you. Which is also known as the father of genetics.